if you don't have Adobe software or the other fancy software, doesn't mean it's the end of the world. You can achieve amazing looking logos using our beloved Canva. Today, we are creating this abstract minimalistic logo. We're going to achieve gaps as well. We're not even going to use the background remover to achieve gaps. We're going to be using our shapes. So let's jump in and do this. From your homepage, you're going to create a blank canvas. We're going to use the logo blank canvas. And then we're going to go to our elements and start creating shapes on our canvas. You can press R for rectangle, or you can go and get the rectangle shape. Then you're going to adjust it. We can change the color green. Once you've created your rectangle, you're going to then create another rectangle. And then you're gonna make this size a bit smaller so that it can create the V effect on our first rectangle. So what we're trying to create here is this shape. And you're going to change color for that one and make it white so that you have that effect. You're going to copy the same white rectangle, move it to the bottom of the page so that you have the same effect at the bottom of the page, like that. Then you're going to copy this and duplicate it so that you have the H effect. Once you have your H effect done and dusted, you're going to create another rectangle. You're now creating your windows at the bottom of the design. We're creating a real estate logo. So we're going to have a house with windows. We'll copy and paste your shapes like that, and then duplicate them so that it is a nice window kind of a design. I'm gonna group this, take it to a little bit above, and then change color to a dark green for that windows. And then you're going to add text. You press T for text, or you go to your element to add text. We're going to use our lovely font, the League Spartan. And we're gonna give the name of this company as Happy Homes. When I was doing this design, I wanted to leave it as Happy Homes so that people can read it with the big H. But the mind sees the words first and it looks weird. That's why I went and I looked for an H and I added a nice H that goes with this real estate design, because we don't want to confuse people who are looking at this real estate design for this customer. They would understand that this is a real estate. Somebody's selling beautiful, happy homes. That's why we are going to go to the elements and look for an H. And then you're going to scroll down and find that gorgeous looking H that is with the square that goes with the design. Awesome. And you're going to reduce size, move it to over there, change color, and then adjust your design so that it makes sense. Next, you're going to look for a roof. So you're gonna go to your elements and you're gonna search for roof. And then you're gonna look for a roof on your graphics until you find the roof that you would like to use. I liked this one. So you just click on it once and then you size it over your design like that. The last thing that you're going to do is to create the interlock between the H and the roof of the house. So we can change the color and make it the light green, the light beautiful green. And then we are going to create the interlock. So creating the interlock is going to be nice and interesting because we're going to use our shapes for that. So the first thing you're going to do is to go copy this rectangle, Control C and Control V, so that you have that rectangle. Then you're going to move it and size it ever so gently so that it covers this section. You're creating your interlock just like that. Then you're going to copy this to make a duplicate of that. And you create the bottom section of your interlock. Now you're going to click on your roof, send it to front because you want to see how it looks like. If you're not happy with the gaps, how they look like, you then send your roof at the background and you tweak it so that you are happy with how it looks and how it merges. See, this bottom side is perfect. Now we just need to fix the top. I like that. It's interlocking quite nicely. And that is how you get the shape to have that interlock. Now we're going to interlock the roof so that this rectangle is on top of our roof. So what you would do is you would copy the roof, Control C and Control V to have a duplicate of the roof, move the duplicate on the side, and then click on the roof, go select crop, and then crop the roof so that it goes to the side, and then it creates that line for us to have that interlock effect. We're happy with that. We go and we size it exactly on top of that other roof, and then we go crop the second section and we move it so that we have interlock. We click on done, and our logo is almost done because we need to remove the background, and it would make sense when we move over to Photopea. So what you would then do is you click on share, scroll down to download. You're gonna then download the 2D, scroll down, click and add a second page. Drag the 2D that you just downloaded and paste it on the blank page. Then size it to the size that you would like that, and then click on the image itself, select edit image, and then click on remove background on Canva. If you don't have remove background, you can try it for 30 days using the link below. Once the software has removed the background, you click on apply and we are good to go. You're then going to click on share, scroll down to download. We're going to download as a transparent background page number 2, and we're going to click on done and download. And now our 2D is finally downloaded, and it's ready for us to jump in on Photopea to create a 3D effect. So you're gonna go on Photopea. The easiest way of converting a 2D to 3D is to use the PSD templates that the creators are sharing with us on Photopea. You're going to click on PSD templates, select mockups, and then you're going to pick any mockup that you'd like. They've loaded a very number of them that are available for you to use. So So don't struggle with downloading unless it's something that it's different and it's not available and you would like a different one. You're welcome to check any of my videos that I've used to help you download a PSD mockup. I like this one, so I'm gonna click on it and then select the photopea.com link. It then loads the mockup. You then double click where it says your logo here, and then you hide your logo design here using this eye, and then you click and you hold and you drag your design that you've just downloaded and you've created from Canva. If it doesn't show like mine, then you need to go File, Open and Place, and go and find it on your downloads. You then click and hold to size your design. You center it nice this way. Then you click on File, Save as Smart Object, and then it saves as Smart Object. Then you click once where it says Logo Mockup. And there, your logo, done and dusted, beautiful, interlocking. You are then able to file and export it as a PNG, JPEG, or whichever file format that you like. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to go live and help you with this process of converting to 3D, because I'm getting a lot of questions. So I'm happy to help with a live session. Watch out for my course that I'm busy creating for Canva. Thank you for joining me today. I really do appreciate the time that you spend with me. I will see you on the next video.